Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Abaddon the Black Fortress. So we finished dealing with this Drake Josa Mindtaker at this Beraza Woods, inside Beraza Woods. Unfortunately, three blades from Kelem, which went with us, died in the end. She fully charmed and controlled them. But it seems like it was a good outcome, and there is a chance for peace now, actually, because of that, because many Torshigas think that they died proudly, helping to defend this Beraza forest, and now they can actually continue negotiation with Duke Griffin, after he reports back to his superiors. So there is hope for full peace between Hawklander and Kalimdri. And here we are, reporting all the quests that we have done in the previous episodes. And now we are reporting to Kalanza, who seemed surprisingly friendly merchant towards a pact. So I spoke with Gatemaster on your behalf. She smiles wickedly.
Yes, I know. He sent me word that I can pass through Webex without restriction. Send the message the moment you left his office, I suspect. I've beaten Trader Caron, but I'm done with him yet. I'm not done with him yet. And yes, I know I must pay you, and generously.
She gives you a lot of points.
I'm grateful for your aid.
Anything else I can do for you? She thinks about this.
I'm not sure. Now that I have reliable contacts, I need to think about the opportunities open to me. I'm not ready to act yet.
Okay. I wonder if your prices are still too crazy. Yeah, they're a bit less crazy than they was, I think, if I remember correctly. But they're still exorbitant. I'm not going to buy anything from you. But I'm still fine with, like, not buying anything from Haron, because you don't have anything useful anyway. So here's our report done. And let's go back to castle and report more quests there. Castle Webex. Okay. Let's see what other quests we have completed here. We completed Orion, that was on the main floor. And magic samples, I think that was also on the main floor. And Commander, this was also on the main floor. Bounty Basilisks. Actually, I don't remember where this basilisk was. The kennel, I think it also on the main floor. Alright, so this trader, he didn't have anything useful, right? Let's just check it, just in case. Yeah, nothing good here, and no, he had Titan Steel Chainmail, which is slightly better than what I have, but it doesn't really matter. And he has this Titan Steel Girdle, which has a lot more armor. And I think I should buy it, actually. Like, I don't really care about this Titan Steel Chainmail. It's not much better than my Steel Breastplate. And Titan Steel Shield adds just 4 additional. And Curse Resistance. Like, Curse Resistance doesn't matter at all. I don't deal much damage with my tank anyway. So Curse Resistance doesn't matter. Mind resistance would, but it's not mind resistance. So I only care about this Titan Steel Girdle, and it actually adds 7 armor. And it gives a chance to evade instead of chance to parry, though. No, I think it's still worth buying. Yeah, let's buy it. And let's put it on. And I don't think anybody needs this. Yeah. But I may use this belt on my warriors. That's the only thing. On the other warrior that I have back in Avedon Fortress. Okay, let's continue and let's check another guy. This is also a trader. Let's trade. And no, I can't really sell anything for you, but do you have anything useful for me? Like, you have Drake skin. Should I even buy it? Like, I have two already. Yeah, let's buy it just in case, so I don't need to go back and seek it if I need it later. And this chainmail, I don't think I need it. This strange reward. Maybe I will need cold resistance eventually. Okay, I'll keep it just in case, but I think I will sell it quite soon anyway. Ruby, I think I will also keep on you. Strength, dexterity, and wits. Alright. And then let's go back to the main floor and report there and enchant all the items we have. This enchantment. These enchantment runestones. And who we want to report to? Commander office. Well, it doesn't seem like Kennels is down up here. It seems like I actually missed them down here, right? Where's the Kennels? Yes, here is the Kennels. Let's report here then. And where is our Tender Melisandre? Tender Melisandre, I killed these 5 basilisks. This is good news for us. As a reward, I will give you some items that will aid greatly in basilisk hunting. Now that I think of it, perhaps I should have given them to you before the hunt, not after. She gives you a wand and 2 crystals. I'm pleased to help a hand of Avedon. And if you wish another bounty, there are other things I need.
And what is that?
Well, there were lots of basilisks in the woods near the castle. I'm hoping that they might have laid some eggs.
And yes, I found your eggs already.
I have found the eggs of this creature to be oddly difficult to obtain. Very fragile, you see, and survive long journeys. Return to the woods and see if you can find some of their eggs. You'll be rewarded, I assure you.
Yeah, I already found them, so here you are. She takes the eggs, holds them up to the light, sniffs them, and nods her approval.
I think that the 2 or 3 of them are still viable. We will see if the creatures are eager to tame them, if I tame them from birth.
She has an assistant fetch a helmet for you. It is a beautiful Kalem craftsmanship.
I thank you for your assistant. The skill of Avedon is great.
Anything else I can do for you?
Perhaps later.
Okay then. Thank you for your reward and for level for 2 of my characters. I appreciate it. And I can go up and report other quests while I'm at it. And I remember I had a quest from Commander... what was your name? Commander Pollen or something? Commander Peveral. Okay. So, I'll report to you now. Commander Peveral, I dealt with this smuggler tunnel. You tell the tale. Peveral is pleased. I thank you on behalf of my duke and the royal treasury. He pays you a generous satchel of coins. I hope that you find this reward adequate for your travels.
Is there anything else I can do for you?
He looks through the papers on his desk. Not at this point. Give me some more time to find a task equal to your skills. Come and ask me later. Okay. Apparently, I will have ending. I will see ending of these talks, and that would be when that will happen. You will give me more tasks. And okay, so this is a leather worker shop. I wonder where I saw that task from. Okay, yeah, Acacia, I also had a quest from you. I followed Orion. He was leaving messages for the Talon Empire. You tell the tale, including the news of Orion's escape.
A Talon spy. Another one. The Talon Empire has been only busy of late. Redburn will learn this.
She takes a scarab out of your desk, looks at it, shakes your head, and replaces it. Instead, she removes three gemstones and hands them to you.
Thank you for the information. I will make sure that the news of Orion's crime spread.
She also unlocks her spare room for you.
Help yourself to everything but what is in the box.
Okay. Anything else I can do for you? Though I definitely will prefer that scarab and to the random gemstones.
Of course. And I would find it to be a surprise. If you see Orion, catch him. Or sense that it will probably be inconvenient, kill him. In troubled times, we must make it clear that spies will not be tolerated.
The charming old woman sips her tea, seemingly unconcerned by the death she has just ordered.
You will be rewarded.
Yeah, I will be. And I can guess that I would find him right now, and I'm not sure where I will find him eventually. Yeah, I can't take anything from the box, and there is not much things elsewhere. Yeah, there is Scroll of Resurrection and titled Titan Steel Spear, which I can sell, and a view. And let's see what I got from other quests reward. Wand of Calling. Yeah, I might use it. I will give it to my mage. Emerald Stone. I just sell it. All inactive abilities that turns 15 turns earlier. Well, I'm not sure if I need it. Really, like, not on this character, and I'm not sure if I need it on anybody at all. Maybe on my mage. Okay, I'll keep it for my mage. And let's see what helm I have. And that's quite good helm that give hit chance. And the same armor. Let's see what armor we have here. Yeah, I will give this hit chance to my archer because my warrior don't really need it. Even though my archer probably have like maximum hit chance, I will still give it to him just in case. And this steel helmet I don't need. Okay then, let's see. Now I want to find alchemist. I don't remember where this alchemist was. Really? Maybe that alchemist was also downstairs and not upstairs here? Or was it somewhere here? Maybe it was somewhere here actually. Let's check. It looks like magic circles for summoning of demons. So, yeah, here it is. Incantatrix Questa. Incantatrix Questa, I have that goo that you wanted from a breeding pit. You open the jar and show her the green goo, still shifting around under its own power. Her eyes light up.
Powerful stuff! Forbidden, but intriguing! Can I have it? I will reward you.
Well, yeah, I brought it for you just for the quest. So, if you do something wrong with it, I will just kill whatever monsters you created. So, yeah, take it. She takes it reverently and seals the jar.
Yes, we will be careful. Study this magic. Marvelous. In return, I will give you...
She gives you one of her old magical rods. It is dinged up a bit, but still powerful.
Also, when you trade with me, I can bless you. The materials for the spells are expensive, but you'll find it to be worth it.
Well, I don't think I'll need your blessing. It is not permanent, I would guess, right? So, do you need anything else? She thinks.
Yes.
There is a long pause.
What? Oh, you mean now? No, 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 not yet. Return later. I may have more of the present hands who want more powerful magical rewards.
Well, cool. I will return eventually. And let's look at this rod. It's quite interesting rod, indeed. Let's give it to our mage and see if it's better than what we have in our mage currently. Well, no, it gives additional strength and dexterity and chance to parry, but it is basically the same damage, and what's more important, it doesn't have this bonus 5 magical damage. So, I don't think this rod is even useful in the first place. Maybe on the healer though, it will be good. Maybe. Like, no, probably not. Probably I should just sell it. It's kinda unique, but it's actually worse than this non-unique wizard stuff. Oh wait, it's a rod. So it's a one-handed item, right? Let's check it. It probably is. Yes, it is one-handed item. Then it's better than this wizard stuff because it has this additional strength and dexterity in parry bonus, and I can put on this buckler, which also have the same magical damage and chance to parry and armor, and it's basically almost the same now in damage as wizard stuff, just one point lower, but it gives a lot of additional armor and parry, and it is what we were lacking a lot. So I will gladly use it instead of this wizard stuff. And I think I already have that wizard stuff on my healer. Well, I'll check it later. I'll check it. Okay, there is all kinds of random stuff here. Let's talk with these Encantrix. I don't remember where I saw Forge. I think it was on the lower floor next to that useless meat. Let's talk with you and stop running around. Okay, thank you. I want to trade with you and... Oh, I see, so this is actually permanent blessing. Like the training. Ah, okay, so you provide blessing. They are difficult, but I can provide them only 3,000 coins each for expenses. One blessing will protect you from the blades of your enemies, the other shield from the attack of your mind. Yes, I will want that. But first, I will want to see. I really don't have the money for it, unfortunately. Probably I should sell all the trash that I won't be using. I think I won't be using. And maybe I can just ignore these runstones for now, because they will be applied for just one item, and this will be applied forever. And I really need protection from mental attacks, that's for sure. Okay then, you convinced me. I will come back soon, and first though I will report the last quest, like the main quest. And then I will go and sell whatever I'm not likely to use, most likely I would not, and purchase at least mental protection from you, and maybe even light protection if I have enough money. And let's talk with... Alright, Scribe, you don't have any quests, I'm just checking. No, you don't. So now let's report to this Duke Griffin, our main quest. So, I have completed my investigation of the pit. Duke described in detail what happened in the Bonanza pits
He reacts to the news of the death of his soldiers with great calm.
Their family will be honored to know that they sacrificed their lives for a worthy cause. Monitor Shigas has already returned, and his version of the tale matches you exactly. And I'm pleased to say the deaths of Kerkelen warriors touched him greatly. Please, return to Redbird and thank him on my behalf for your help. This is a very promising beginning for a long task.
So Shigas will walk with you?
There has been no result so dramatic. Shigas also is surprised and intrigued, but he still hates and fears Calendril. Many long conversations lie ahead before the next step.
So I will return to Avadon.
I wish you a safe journey, and I'm sure that my scrub will thank you for not taking up my time.
Okay. I wonder if a scribe will actually reward me somehow. And I got my achievement, Peace Within the Pact. Apparently that was enough or almost enough. So you would thank me? Well, you didn't, but anyway. And that was a good quest, good reporting it. So let's take a look what we have that we would not need. This charm of power would probably not need. These mantles. Alright, it's a different fire resistance, acid resistance stuff. We might need that. I think we don't need this enduring breastplate. And let's sell it. And now, what else we can sell? This is also resistances. I think we don't need this tunic. No. Platinum ring, it seems like it would be needed in any quest. And these boots, no. These monkey greaves, well, probably not. Let's sell them. Titan's short sword. I'm not sure if I will ever take my tank with me, like ever. That other tank. But even if I do, his items is worse than what I'm selling, but it's not much worse. So, intelligence and critical hit chance. Huh. I wonder if I should give this critical hit chance instead of intelligence. What would be better? Yeah, let's use this critical hit chance to get as close to 100 as possible. This belt I don't need. Really, like almost anything that I have here I don't need. These two items I will put on my other guys. And alright. I'll keep these items just in case. You will take these items and keep them in case I'll need a really high resistance against cold or fire eventually, and that will probably happen. One more item is cold resistance. Blinking pants. And they don't cost anything. Alright. These greaves. I will sell it. And random ones. Yeah, I will sell them as well. I can call a red. Well, whatever. Okay, let's call a red. Anything. Mage stuff. Okay, this buckler is worse, but it can be used for a healer. That takes quite some time to sort out all the stuff I have now. Alright, this is poison resistance, we'll keep it probably. This we don't need. Sage Road we don't need anymore, that's for sure. A hidden bracelet, let's keep it, I think. magic damage. Yeah, we'll give it to Ade, to healer, mock all resistance, and intelligence one. Probably I can also give it to healer. Let's see what else I have. Yeah, probably I don't need this elves and barrels of iron stuff. Do I need charm force? Would I even use it? That costs some money. And there is few crystals here and there. Like this fortune, shield, whatever else. Curing brew, which, like, I don't really need it. What else can I sell? Group cure is very good. I definitely keep it. Wine, I don't need this wine. And elixir of recovery. Well, let it be for now. And let's see how much money I will get when I sell whatever I already put for sale. Probably not 6,000 that I want. Let's see. Let's trade. And I want to sell all this trash in the bag. And I didn't even get 3,000, so I definitely need to sell more. Alright then. Alright. Let's see what else we want to sell. All these items that give a bit of cold resistance and stuff, they all cost almost nothing. Potion of speed. Okay, let's just sell all things that we can, because we don't really need them. Let's just put all these things for sale, like this cold fire resistance. No, I'm so torn between selling and not selling them, because they might be useful in dealing with some random demons or something, and then I will really like them, but on the other hand, I don't really need. So hard to grasp. Let's trade again. I want to sell a trash in the bag. And let's sell these crystals actually. Let's get 3000 and get magical protection. And then we'll get physical protection at some point later when we'll have a possibility for it. Good opportunity and more money. Let's sell these potions. How much now I have? Well, still not enough. Let's sell something else. This one. Yes. Now I should have enough money, right? Yes, now I have enough money. Though I don't have enough money to purchase all these crystals for upgrades, but well, we can get everything at once, right? Yeah, let's use this forge to add some enchantments while we are here. Is there anything I would definitely use till the end? I'm not sure about that. Even this endurance, charm of endurance, I might replace. So I don't know if I want to enchant anything from my tank. But I will enchant something from my archer. And yes, I don't think I will need this strength stone as well. But this endurance stone I will keep and maybe use them later in the future. So, let's enchant. What do we will use for sure on our archer? This the die belt, I think we will use. Okay, let's enchant it. Let's add dexterity bonus to it. Nice. And now we have even more dexterity. And let's take a level up as well. And then we'll just go back to Avedon and report to our direct superiors that we succeeded in doing the quest. In this peace talks, that peace talks really now have a good opportunity of success. Finally making peace between Hawkander and Galadriel. Okay, let's level up first. Endurance. Yes. And at the next level, we finally get will get final point in Pass of Berserk. What I want to get after that, I'm not. Probably War Cries. Like this. And our mage will get more and more intelligence and more magical master. Yep. Let's go back to Avedon. Now let's see who we should report to. So Redbird sent me there, but I'm not sure if I should report to him or to Hurt Miranda. I will go check with Hurt Miranda first. Okay, so I have to report to Redbird actually. Alright, and that's an interesting question. Hurt Miranda, you are always here. We are always working. Is there always this much chaos? She starts to give you a quick, sharp dismissal, but something stops her. She sighs, sets down her pen, and sits back in her chair. It is not normal. These troubles. I have had this post for a long time. I do not often get tired, but... She shakes her head. How long have you served here?
30 years. 30 years, long enough that I'm called his wife. Me... His wife, it...
She rests her chin on her chest for a long moment. At first you think she might have fallen asleep. Then her head snaps up, she laughs.
It has been a long time. I don't know why I do it, except of course... For the wealth and power.
So you're wealthy?
You have roamed the news. You have seen how poor most of our lands are. We're still trying to recover from many decades of war. Compared to them, we live in constant luxury when we are not out fighting.
And you have much power here, right?
This desk looks humble, does it not? And yet, from here I send warriors and assassins. All the known lands. Redbird makes a few big decisions. I make many little ones. And the little ones matter greatly. Yes, they do.
You'll ever retire?
And if I did, if I set foot outside this fortress to face the grudges of the families of all that we have acted against, how long do you think I would last? And you? Do you think you will ever leave Avedon's service?
I don't think so.
A noble wish, and one that is always granted in the end.
She shakes her head and picks up her pen.
We must return to business.
Okay, I don't want to tell you what I learned in the dungeon, because that is probably a dark way. Like, we can use it to make you go against Abaddon if you want Hades to succeed and kill everybody. But that's not a good thing. Why would we even do that? Well, and maybe we can get some money from her this way, but I don't see good reason to do so. At least not now. Let's go and report to Redbird that we succeeded in this peace talks. I am back from Castle Webbers. Describe what happened. You tell Redbird how Calendril and Colclanda walked together to rid the Brazil Woods of a dangerous monster. He's pleased.
A small beginning, but better cooperation between the two than we have seen since the Black Age.
Redbird presents you with a scarab.
I will send word to Lord Griffin, encouraging him. That lord has much potential. Perhaps we can build on this auspicious beginning. You have done well. I told to have Miranda. Perhaps she will have more work for you. If not, you will have a much deserved rest.
Well, I can guess that she will have a lot more work for me. So I will definitely return for her, because what else we will do if she don't have any quests? Well, then there might be some other quests, but from somebody else, but she should have a quest for us. Heard Miranda, hello. You have more orders for me? Redbird sent me back here. What are my orders? Heard Miranda grimaces and pulls a fresh message from the top of a stack of pages.
It is a report from one of our mages. It is based on the beast flesh and you brought back to us from Chimera. And as expected, it shows that the creature was made by the dark magic hidden from Abaddon. This, combined with the earlier insolence, is completely unacceptable. You must return to the Farlands to...
She checks the paper.
The Holstead! Find the wizard responsible for this and kill him or her and bring what you can of the criminal's research back to me.
Well, just as I expected, that will be on our next quest. Back in the Holstead. So, is Lorella still here?
She is. She has been encouraged to leave, but she remains. Perhaps she has some fitting desire to speak for her people. You can speak with her if you wish. You might learn something useful, though I do doubt it.
So, the mage must be killed, obviously?
Yes. Whoever is responsible must die. In less dying times, we might have been in a more forgiving mood, but I have had a terrible few weeks and I am in the mood to make someone an example.
And so do I. So how should I proceed?
Return to Chimera, enter the fortress of Ochrintor and confront the local lord. Perhaps he will be honest and forthright with you and spare his own insignificant thing. If he does not help you, start breaking things until someone does. It is very important that the work that created this monstrosity ends now.
And stupid question, why is this made so dangerous?
Such magical experiments can create diseases, plagues, or pests, deadly monsters that can attack the pact and do enormous harm. Of all that work wizards do, such creations are the most forbidden.
Okay, so yeah, that's our next quest, and we will return to Farlands. And between episodes, I will equip everybody and we'll see, level up them as well. And yeah, I should go back. And do what I forgot, and to boost my magic, my mind resistance. That I will also do.
And let's check this hand Callan, who give us a side quest sometime. Is there anything else I can do for you? Not yet. Alright then. So, I don't think it's very fun to watch as I will go around as I level up people and replace items and get that magical protection, mind resistance. So I will do that in between episodes. And I will see you guys when we going to enter this farlands, this Chimeria, and deal with that very, very suspicious mage, which we still have to deal with. And what is, yes, hunting the wizard, this main quest in Chimeria. So, everybody, I hope you like this episode, though smaller than most. But it was still quite interesting, and the reporting all the stuff and getting all the rewards around. So leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode of Abaddon the Black Fortress. Bye bye.